story I got from today, stealing from kind of the last video I did of talking about exciting things as a kid, things that are so exciting. And one of those things I talked about was staying over at a friend's house. So much fun. And also stemmed around Jamie, which I talked about in the last video. Jamie's a really good friend of mine. Probably can't even call him a friend. Really call him a brother, because we've grown up together since we was about 4 years old. Dad worked in the woods together. He moved away for a little while and came back. He's in the fifth grade. And he's just boom, hit it right off like he never even left. But it was sixth grade when this happened. We're at school and all. He said, "Hey man, you wanna come over this weekend?" I'm like, yeah. So I'm talking to the parents to make sure it's all right. Boom, we're off for the weekend. And we're there playing around. We get to playing inside. We get to playing video games, which was awesome to me because we didn't have video games at the house. Mom and Dad didn't let us have that. It was in Nintendo. Do you intend to go outside? Or Xbox, Sandbox, that's what we had. We didn't have none of that. So it was awesome. We was playing for a long, long time. And his sister come out and was like, "Hey, I want to watch TV." He's like, "No, we're playing." He's like, "I want to watch TV." "No, we're playing." They finally get to scuffle around, fighting, and Jamie throws a little Judy flip on her and boom, her head off the carpet. And she had carpet burn on her head for the longest time because Jamie was and is a tough fella, and he ain't about to take nothing off nobody. I remember one time it was seventh grade football. We was getting fitted for pads. And we were down there and one old boy was messing with Jamie, shoving around. And Jamie was a little shorter then. He jumped up and bow, whacked that guy on top of the head and "Leave me alone." That guy quit. He didn't mess with Jamie no more. But we continued playing video games for a while and went on to bed and woke up next morning pretty early. And go outside, we're messing around, playing around, and we find some kerosene. So we're like, we pull a little bit out, light it on fire on the concrete, watch it, and it's awesome, watching a little fire burn. Then we find the ant bed, we poke around in it, set it on fire, burn it. It's awesome. Find another one, ant bed, burn it. It's awesome. Then we found a Mountain Dew can. We're like, what happened? We just fill this up a little bit and set it on fire. So we set it off and fires just shooting out. It burned up. It's awesome. And what about we stick like a piece of paper in it, be like a wick, burn it, see what happens. Do that. It's awesome. Watch the little fire burn. Then we get it. We're like, what if, like, because he had a clothes line in the backyard. What if we hung it from the clothespin and, like, set a fire, see what happened? So we did. Got it going. We're like, let's like, start spinning it. So we start spinning it, and fires just, I mean, blazing out rooster tails. Then he gets in a ring of fire. Needed Johnny Cash in the background playing for us. That's what he just said, going. We're like, let's spin a little faster. We're going. Let it go. And fire just catching oxygen and burning like crazy. And it was still, I mean, awesome at this point. And you know what happens if you flick a Coke can tab long enough? What is it gonna do? It's gonna break. So it finally breaks and takes off into orbit. So it's flying, flames shooting out the back. It's just spiraling. Just a rocket can flying through the air with fire burning at the back end of it. It's still awesome at this point. And then finally gravity starts working on it. So comes back down from its orbit. I'm telling you, this is up there. It's crazy how high it went, but it was whipping pretty hard. And it comes back down. And then it hits the ground. And then it turns not so awful. Awesome. Fire everywhere. And we're like, we're running out there, breaking off pine limbs, and just beating to get it out. And we finally get it out. We come back to the house. We're like, we eat a little breakfast, and his mom comes in there. She's like, come on, boys, I can run some errands and put out some fires. And we're just like, but if she knows, you would have killed us, then we would have died. You wouldn't see me do this story. She may kill us anyway. I see no statute of limitations don't run out with your mom and dad. But also that weekend, this is good too. We got in his dad's truck. Mind you, we're sixth graders. And we started driving around the neighborhood. Just flying around. Muffler comes off one point, falls off. We had to put it back on. Sixth grade. Driving around in his neighborhood with a manual transmission. A bunch of nuts. But anyways, hope y'all enjoyed that one.